Welcome, and thank you so much for joining me, my friends, my fam, my fellow fans of Clash of Clans. It's your host, Galadon, and today we're talking about the most loot that you can humanly possibly gain or lose in Clash of Clans, and a little experiment that was inspired by my recent trip to Legend League and a long stay there. And obviously, if you guys are fans of the channel, you've seen the hashtag boycott Legend League campaign that really kind of backfired on me by the end of the episode, but that's for another day. So yes, what we're going to show today are some amazing raids. The biggest raid ever, going to challenge you guys to find one bigger and reward you if you do, and talk about possibly what was a glitch in the game. Now, right here, we're looking at maybe my last attack before the December update. Obviously, you see the Royal Champion is at level 20 and she's maxed out here. This was a Titan 1 attack on my main account right before the update dropped. Now, obviously, it was good loot, but it was nowhere near the maximum loot that anybody can get in the game as of right now. We'll see that in just a moment. In fact, we'll see it several times and show you how you can do it as well. Not that you would want to, obviously, because the whole idea behind Clash of Clans is not giving away loot, but that's, again, for another video as well. Okay, so this is Queen Charge Hybrid. This is the one-trick pony Galadon using the only attack that I've really become accustomed to. I haven't tried really using the invisibility spells, the log launcher, say, with a ground attack yet. I realize that witches are super strong right now, as is air, ice hounds all over the place, dragons, bat spells, you name it. But here I am doing this attack a whole lot. In fact, pretty much all the time. So what we're going to do is at the end of the video, we will hit a fully maxed out or nearly fully maxed out post-update base and see how this same attack strategy does. And yes, believe it or not, we will be back in Legend League. And I know what I've been saying, but obviously you have to kind of look at it as, do I want the Legend League trophies in case they do make something available with Legend League trophies, or do I want to boycott? And I guess, you know, with that last video, I decided that it probably makes more sense to go ahead and play in Legend League if you feel like it, pick up those Legend League trophies, and gamble that at some point in the future, players will receive rewards for that. Now, this was a pretty close attack. We just get in there in the final 10 seconds, get out that multi-farget Interno, and there you go. 2.7 million in loot, over 11,000 Dark Elixir, but that's not the most you could possibly get. This is how you give away the most possible loot. Everything overflowing, Gold Elixir, Dark Elixir, the treasury completely full, level 10 clan, so I have all of the perks. The gold mines, the elixir pumps, and the drills are all overflowing as well. And this combination should lead to the largest amount of loot possibly given away in a single attack. However, if you guys have been watching the channel for a while, perhaps you remember this video a little while back. This is obviously Town Hall 13. We're a couple of updates ago. But did you see the numbers at the top left at the very beginning of the attack? 1.77 million gold, 1.78 million elixir, and 12,150 dark elixir. The reason that number is significant, well, we'll see in just a moment. Obviously, this base was not set up maybe to defend, kind of a gift. Obviously, also, this was somebody who had their base in pretty much the same state that my base was when I went out on defense in Titan League. And remember, your clan level matters because as your clan levels up, your treasury will hold more loot, enabling you to lose more loot. Okay, so there you go, right there. That is the number I am challenging you to beat. Beat that number either on offense or defense. Show me the replay in my clan or yours and I will give you a $25 gift card of your choosing. Now, this is my defense log. Of course, we did recently have the update, so you'll notice that the two big losses were 1.77, 1.77, and 12,150. Lost the replays because of the update. That kind of hurt, but that's why we went back and saw the even bigger raid. But notice, as my loot decreased, so did the amount of loot that the attackers were gaining. Until Mehmet attacked me and gained zero loot. That's right. With over 700,000 gold and elixir, 5,500 dark elixir available, all sitting up there at the top of this base. This was perhaps as big of an accomplishment as getting the most possible loot, and that is getting the least possible loot. Now, I don't think that this player made a mistake. I don't think that he actually, you know, failed to get the loot that he was going for. This appears to be intentional. So let's just take a look at how this happened, because it was very well planned out to take zero loot. And what I mean by that is, okay, the lightning spells took out all of the air defenses, which were clumped together. The dragons come in at the bottom. He dropped one solo dragon on the eagle first to make sure that the eagle was out as well. So now the dragons work their way through every single defense. At the top left of your screen, that dragon is getting closer and closer to the loot. Notice he's going through the barracks right there, just about to get to the treasury, and that will be the first loot gained in this raid. But in the meantime, the dragons have crossed the 50% threshold. He's gotten the victory. He's going to win some trophies. And maybe that's all he wanted. Maybe that's all he needs. Because right here, as the dragon goes to work on the clan castle, he ends the raid. He ended the raid and took exactly zero loot. I'm telling you right now, I consider this a gift. I think it was kind of funny that this happened. And I was happy to give away the loot. Perhaps he didn't need it. So there you go. All right. So the world record most and least. Obviously, you guys aren't going to be able to beat the smallest amount of loot. So let's go ahead and try to beat the biggest amount. And by the way, the best way to reach me is on Twitter, at Galadon Gaming. I don't check or get my Instagram or TikTok messages, but I do get my Twitter mentions. So if you mention me on Twitter with a screenshot of that huge loot, and you have, of course, asterisk, the replay must be available in-game. I cannot just take a screenshot, okay? Get to my clan, I'll invite you, or I'll come to your clan, we'll check it out. If you can beat that number, the 1.77, 1.78, 12150, $25 Amazon, iTunes, or Google Play gift card is yours as your finder's fee. All right, so on to the big attack. This is my very first Legend League attack post-update. You'll see that the base, not fully maxed out, but at least we've got two expos firing the blue shots. The blue flame, which I think is super cool. Definitely looking forward to, hopefully, fingers crossed, blue flames coming out of the next level of Inferno Tower. I'm guessing, however, that will wait until Town Hall 14, and I'm also thinking summer to fall of 2021 is when we could likely expect to see a Town Hall 14 update. So those of you still reeling from the recent update saying I can't possibly get maxed out, don't give me any more stuff to do yet, I don't think you have to worry, although you never know. We could see another Clash update between now and Town Hall 14, and who knows what could be in store then. I'll tell you, I expected a little something more in this winter update. I was kind of looking for, rather than just new levels and new super troops, I was looking for some change in the game mode, something more to do with, say, clan alliances. Remember how I've talked about global chat never coming back? But perhaps maybe we could have alliance chat. Maybe we could have a way to link sister clans. Maybe we could have another way to get clan members to work together in concert to defeat a common enemy, something like that. I've talked about these things for literally years in my videos, and I hope that we will see something like that in a future update. But for now, obviously, this is what we have for the rest of the year. Although I'm not complaining. I'm pretty happy with what we saw. I'm just anticipating that we'll see some major, crazy changes to Clash of Clans in the next year. So that is it for this attack. We did pick up a perfect triple, our first Legend League attack of our first Legend League day back since we decided to boycott Legend League. But I still haven't decided whether we want to stay in Legend League or drop out. What we should do with that, you guys could always let me know down in the comments as well what you think, what ideas you have for future updates, and of course, what you think about this last update. Not that it matters, because it's here and we got to deal with it, right? And that means time to try to grind and max out everything that they've given us to work on. And I just hit level 255. How about that? That was pretty cool. With that attack, with that town hall, I gained the experience to push me over level 255. That is epic. I'm excited about those levels. It's something to do. And there it is. Perfect Legend League day. Thank you, Galafan, for sticking around all the way to the end of the episode. Take care of yourselves. Be safe. You know I love, think about, and appreciate every single one of you every single day. So get out there, make the best of the rest of your day. Be kind to other people, animals, and blind. I'll see you back here again tomorrow for more full attacks.
Galadon, you talk slow and then you talk so fast. You go from 0 to 60 faster than a P100D.